Hello students, a people without the knowledge of their past history, origin and culture is like a tree without roots, Marcus Grewe. We are not makers of history, we are made by history, Martin Luther King. Yes, these views are of two great peoples about history. The same way, there is a relation between history and geography. Already, we took information about it in our lesson number 1 and lesson number 2. In our today's video, we are going to revise these lessons. So students, we are going to start with our lesson number 1, the Indian subcontinent and history. Now in this lesson, we are going to see 4 points, or we are going to revise the lesson with these 4 points. Point number 1, history and its pillars. See, now what is mean by history? History is a coherent account of the significant past events in the progress of human civilization. Coherent means already you learned that it is consistent. Okay. And time, place, society and individuals are the 4 major pillars of history. Now second point, geographical conditions and history. Already I told you that history and geography, these 2 subjects are correlated subjects. Point number 1, the component place is related to geographical conditions. Second, history and geography are inseparable. What is mean by inseparable? Means we are not able to separate it. Okay, they are together. Third, history is influenced by geographical conditions. Four, diet, clothing, housing, occupation, and in fact, all human life in any region depends on its geographical characteristics. Therefore, we find differences in the lifestyle of the people of the hilly region and those of the plains. Already, their lifestyle is changed. 5. The climate, the rainfall, agricultural produce, flora and fauna of the region are the main sources of livelihood. Point number 6. Human settlements have flourished wherever the means of livelihood are plenty. 7. Degradation of the environment means lower in quality, drought, invasions, etc. lead to scarcity of means and people are forced to leave their settlements. Scarcity means lack. Okay. Now with these 7 points, already we took information about geographical conditions and history. Now next point, that is geographical features of India. See, India is a large country having Himalaya to its north, the Bay of Bengal to its east, the Arabian Sea to west and the Indian Ocean to south. Second, bearing the Andaman Nicobar Island in the Bay of Bengal and Lakshadweep in the Arabian Sea, India has a contiguous geographical area. Third, Pakistan and Bangladesh were parts of India before 15th August 1947. Okay, means in our geographical feature of India, we already took information about these all points. Okay, now point number 4 and the last, that is geographical regions. Now which regions are here? See, the principal geographical regions of India are above. See, 1. The Himalaya. 2. The plains of river Sindhu, Ganga and Brahmaputra. 3. The Thar Desert. 4. The Deccan Plateau. 5. The coastal regions. And the 6th, the islands in the sea. Okay, in this way we took information about the Indian subcontinent and history. Yes or not? Now, we are going to our lesson number 2, sources of history. And we are going to revise this lesson also. Now, for this, here also some points are there. 6 points are there.
First point, sources of history. See, a number of objects used by our ancestors still exist. Some inscriptions from past have been recovered. These sources helps us to understand history. Yes or not? Means our ancestors who got some objects or they used some objects, and by them we can understood our history. The second, that is the customs and traditions. Folk arts and folk literature and historical documents helps us to understand history. Third, all these are known as the sources of history. Means whatever material or whatever things our ancestors got, that are known as the sources of our history. Now, these sources are classified into three types. The first one, material sources. The second one, written sources. And third one, that is oral sources. Okay. Now, material sources. The artifact, articles, monuments of their runs are called material sources of history. Okay. Third one, written sources. In the Stone Age, people have recorded many events and expressed emotions in paintings on rocks. The second, later man used symbols and signs to record thoughts. Third, thousands of years later, script was developed. Four, in the beginning, man wrote on potsherds, unpicked bricks by using pointed objects. He also used burj patra, bark of a birch tree, to write. Five, as a man's knowledge and experience increased, he began to use various forms of writings. The proceedings in the royal court were recorded in writing. The edicts, decrees and deeds of kings were inscribed on stone or copper plates. Many forms of literature, such as poetry, plays, books on social and religious subjects, travelogues and scientific writings developed. All these together form the written sources of history. Now, whatever I told you now, these all are the examples of written sources. Okay. Now, oral sources. Ovis, folk songs, folk tales and similar literature are passed on from generation to generation by word of mouth. Second, the author of this unwritten literature is unknown. And literature preserved by oral tradition is the oral sources of history. Means whatever things are orally told to one generation to another generation, that is known as the oral sources. Now, sources of ancient Indian history. First point, we have a large number of material, written and oral sources of ancient Indian history. Second, material sources are artifacts and structural remains. Third, the written sources include the stone inscriptions, copper plates, Harappan seals, Vedic literature, Jain and Buddhist religious texts, travelogues of the foreigners, literary and non-literary works. 4. Vedic, Jain and Buddhist literature, which was earlier in oral form, is now available in written form. However, the tradition of rote continues. Now, the last point, or the sixth number point, that is precautions to be taken while writing history. Now, some precautions which were taken by them. See, it is necessary to take precautions while using these sources to write history. These precautions are, the first one, critical examination of written documents, and the second, cross-checking of conclusions from various sources. Okay, in this way, we revised our lesson number second also. Means our lesson number one, lesson number two was revised by us. Okay, now in next video, we are going to learn our new or the next lesson.